golden spot to treat hair. So other manufacturers have a variable spot size, but usually it's longer. And in practice, they, if they want to be effective, they need that short cross solution. So we didn't choose to make it variable. If the skin type is too dark to treat, then we go to the NDAC anyway. Advantage of
like when I want, maybe in my mind I want to use 4 milliseconds, it's actually the moment to change the density. Because I will use 4 milliseconds because the skin is probably double.
Having a 1064 powerful NDX gives us the same possibilities as the Zio and the XLV to treat all vascular lesions that we can't treat with those two devices. So we have the possibility to have all those vascular treatments, and with that big handpiece, it's a little bit heavy, but you are able to do a laser genesis also. So you can go to that 0.3 millisecond setting and do laser genesis. So this is the handpiece. It's a little bit heavier, bigger than the one from the XLV. Why? Because the spot size is 18 millimeters, and in a hair removal setting, we need to be able to keep that temperature of the window at 4 degrees Celsius. It's a very, very effective cooling, which by the weight of the handpiece and the pressure that you put on the handpiece compresses the skin a little bit, so your light source is getting closer to the hair follicle, and by applying that pressure, the cooling gets better, and also your pain gets reduced. Applying a pressure also reduces your chromophore on the vascular part. So you chase away your hemoglobin target by pressing the skin. So that's why this more or less heavy handpiece is an advantage in the treatment. Okay, so these are the specifications for the NDX. So pulse durations from 0.1, that's why you were able to do the genesis. It's a 14 kilowatt peak power, so the same as with the Zio. So it's a very high power NDX system. It's also real-time calibration, like I said, with all computer devices. The spot size is also with this motorized handpiece, so you can just switch on the screen your spot size. You don't need, like in several other competitors, you need to switch handpieces or you need to put other things to change the spot size. Here you just change it on the screen and you can. There is no need to calibrate, it's all done automatically on the fly. This is the screen, so we can select the wavelength, of course, 755 here. It's a fixed millisecond, fixed pulse duration. Here you can select the speed up to 2 Hz. And this is just the fluence, and here this is the place where you change the temperature of the window, and here you can just change the spot size. All very, very simple.
Do you imagine how quick is 2 hertz? It's like really like it goes by the legs. It's really, I'm sitting in the back and I start. Really, really, very fast.
And it's very, it's very high power because of that 3 milliseconds.
One bit jump, jump.
Yes.
Because you want to glide.
Yes, and also that, that coupling, the index matching of to avoid reflection.
What I use actually is aloe vera, like total clear gel. I use it because actually it's at the same time also the after treatment. So it means I put once, I put a gel, and I do my treatment, and I don't need to clean up anymore, and already the after treatment is already on the skin. So actually I'm nearly done.
There are systems on the market that have the same wavelength, that are actually diode lasers with 755 nanometer wavelength. They're completely different in efficacy because they don't have that power to go to the short pulse durations. One of my clients that has the XLHR now had the Soprano eyes from Alma laser, and they had like 50% of their patients were happy, and the other 50 were not happy. And I told them, just try our XLHR and on the unhappy patients, on the unhappy group. And then after a while, they all asked for the other one, for the XLHR and not for the Soprano eyes. And then they, after a period of, I think, 2 months trial, they just bought the unit. And now their Soprano eyes is standing in the corner. So this is the handpiece. The box is a little bit longer than the Zio because you have those two cavities, the NDI and the Alexandrite sitting in the back. But for the rest, the case is identical to the Zio. So it's a small system compared to some of our competitors like Candela or Sanisho. So here you see that compression where you can get closer to that hair follicle. The cooling is reducing the pain a lot. It's really a very...
Almost ice, actually.
Yeah,
it's really
yeah. And then this is this refractive index matching to avoid reflection of the light. This is also a thing that not everybody is aware of. By having that gel and having a contact cooling, you don't allow the burned hair to create a plume in the air. Because the plume in the air from a hair removal treatment is proven to be causing cancer. So if you're the operator doing it all the time, and you inhale that burnt hair, let's say, it's you're putting your health to risk. And we've proven that with our technology, and actually having that plume condensed in that gel, we have like even less than 1% of the plume compared to the ones that don't use. And it's even worse if you have that air cooling system that blows that plume into the air, then you even have more that problem. So there are several reasons why we chose that sapphire cooling. Then
I did it for years, inhaling all those burnt hair. It's true, huh?
It's a study. It's an official study from Massachusetts Hospital in Boston. So, that's the comparison with the Gentle Max from Candela. So it's also 18 millimeters, we have 16 joules, but we need less because they have the reflection of the light, they don't have that index matching mechanism. We have a 3 millisecond, they have 3 milliseconds. Our goes to 2 hertz, I don't know why they put 1 hertz. So this is David Goldberg that did a side-by-side study just to compare the pain sensation in the patients. And here you see XLHR compared to that Gentle Max. So it was obvious that our system is being perceived as much more comfortable, much less pain.
What nice is when you have this cryo cooling, you have just a cooling at that moment that you give the impact. Now you can play also with your cooling. Imagine that you do like a bikini area, it's maybe more sensible. And when you are shooting and you have just 1 moment or second of cooling, sometimes it's short. So with your handpiece, I pre-cool actually the area, then I do the treatment, and then I can post cool. So it's more easy to adapt about the situation.
So to summarize, it's more comfortable than when you don't have that compression and that contact. That's the results.
So this is like 3 months after one treatment. Where one treatment, 3 months, it's for a back, for a man, it's, let's say, surprising, even for me, because it will grow normally a little bit earlier already. 3 months after one treatment, it's enormous, but it's 6 weeks after one treatment. This is just a little movie how it goes. After the treatment, the cooling stays there, so the people feel fresh after the treatment starts.
Yeah, if you only have an XLHR, then 755 is also the wavelength that you can use to treat the metal lesions. I don't think it's the best. But when you only have 755 in your office, you can do it, and it works. But I think other options are better. Pain treatments is the same as with XLP and with Xeo. Laser Genesis is also the same. So it's still hair removal plus some other indications that are very interesting. Here you see why 755 is also a potential wavelength to treat pigmented lesions.
So after two treatments, let's say it is. Buy this machine for hair removal, but you